Today we're looking at this. It's the Metrel MD1160 LCD voltage and continuity tester.
Well done for that one.
Like a short name. So Gary, this must be a trip down memory lane for you with a piece of kit like this.
Yes, so in my previous life, teaching for 19 years, we'd have all our students idolising all the kit that can go in the toolbox, and I'd say to them, a voltage indicator should be one of the first things you buy. Well, this is also a voltage indicator and a continuity tester, Gordon.
Yeah, now a lot of times on the channel, we obviously think there's always value in a quality tool, and obviously a quality tool that's safe is ultra important because this is a safety device, and a lot of people obviously then go off and have a look on a well-known online retailer and find a cheaper version. What we're going to show you today is obviously some of the features of this product, but some of the safety features that are really important. So should we have a look at the look at the tool first, Gary?
Let's have a closer look then. Right. So where would you like to start, Gordon?
Okay, so it's obviously it's two probes. One's fixed to the device itself, and then you've got this wandering lead, which is up to 1.2 metres away, so if you've got big arms, you can test a long way apart.
Okay, yeah, all these things that we're going to talk about sometimes come into something called GS38, don't they, Gordon?
Yes, and I'll put a link in the description below, so that's obviously a very useful document if you're testing electrical systems.
And it's only about 8 to 10 pages long, so very readable as well. So,
okay,
I'm looking at the scale there. It says from 12 to 690 volts. Is that AC or DC or both?
Yeah, so it's AC and DC.
Right, okay.
So that's so you can see it. Obviously, we've got this LCD screen that shows the voltage once it's above 12 volts.
Okay, yep.
And obviously, this bar graph display here, we've got an audible indication. We've got light shown when we've got when we're using it in a continuity mode.
Yes.
And then we've got a hazard indicator which shows when we're in voltage detection mode.
What we really want to know, Gordon, though, is has it got a torch on it?
And it has, it has got a torch as well, so that's handy if you're working possibly in a slightly darkened area and you want to make sure you're probing in the right place.
Okay, so when I press that button then, obviously there's a chance I put it back in my toolbox without obviously pressing it again. How long will it stay on for?
So it'll stay on for 10 seconds.
Oh, right, okay.
So again, this is a device you don't need to switch on or off. It'll switch on when you need to use it. So I guess the first thing we could do is show it in a continuity mode.
Okay, yeah.
So, I mean, I don't know, it's been designed this way, but these probes, when they're held together like this, fit exactly across a British plug top fuse.
Okay, so we have a noise. Yep, we've got no reading on the screen, but we've got the noise, so that's saying we have continuity, isn't it?
So that's, continuity, so a buzzer and the RX light comes on there.
Okay, so the fuse is good, so we know that isn't the problem. So there's a drummer cable here, could you do the same for that? Maybe we were doing a little bit mild testing, wanted to just prove a conductor wasn't broken. Yeah, so we're between the two, and again, yeah, so we know we've got continuity on that conductor.
Yeah, so it also comes with, so again, this is the GS38 part, so these are your essentials for GS38.
So these are your shrouds that go on the tips?
Yeah, so they reduce, obviously, the length of the exposed part of the tip. So obviously, what you don't want to do is short-circuit your probes together.
Okay, and don't want to also have access to the probe when obviously it's touching live parts as well.
So yeah, and another
part, tiny, yeah.
Another part of that is obviously the probes themselves. You see you've got these like finger guards.
Absolutely,
so you're not likely to slip down there and touch the probe ends.
And also some grips here, so shaped or, as well as the finger guards. I like that, yeah. Lots of things that come up in GS38. Remember, that's downloadable in the description. Worth a read. So, where are you going to take us to next then? We see you've got a proven unit over there.
Yeah, so proven unit. Well, what I'd also like to prove is obviously this is a battery powered device, and obviously the batteries will last quite a while because you're not using it. But if I remove the batteries.
All right, okay, so you can take those out.
And this is often the thing on the, you get on the cheaper
ones.
Yeah, if you buy, wander off and just think you can buy any old one that will do the job, this unit should work with no batteries in, or at least indicate a voltage.
Okay, so you're going to turn them around so I can see them. So, if you can turn that all around, so that's good. So I can see. So you reckon that's going to give us a voltage up to 690 volts there?
Yeah.
And I can hear it. I'll get my warning. So there's no batteries in it?
No batteries in it, but we could still say if we'd gone onto a live supply, we're still getting a warning sign.
Okay, it's a must, I would suggest. So we're not relying on the batteries, okay? When obviously the batteries fail or perhaps they're not present, that we still get an indicator that we're on a live supply.
Yeah.
And that proven unit is a live supply, folks, if you haven't seen one of those before. Yeah,
It's another, toolbox essential. As you go through your journey through your electrical career, essential bit of kit as well.
Right, okay. Yeah, that's a good start. So we're going to now see it in action. Okay, I think we flip this round. I think we look at it from a DC point of view. So we said it could go from 12 volts to 690 volts AC and DC, but DC is generally the ones that gets missed out. So I think we look at that next, Gordon.
Yeah, let's have a look.
So we've got a lab power supply here, so we can generate some DC and hopefully see it move up the scale here. We're going to use these 4mm plugs here in order that we can connect into the power supply itself. Don't get confused with these being 4mm and anything to do with GS38. This is the diameter of these and nothing to do with tips. So if we just pop those out, we can screw them onto the end of our probes. So we can bring them in and screw them on, and it'll mean we'll be able to make a really good connection in here. And then I can turn up the voltage, and hopefully we can see it move up the scale. So I'm going to probe in, like so. And now I'm going to wind up the voltage. So here we go. So we are going, I'm at 8 volts DC there. So we're at 8 volts, nothing happening yet. It says it starts registering at 12. So let's see when it does start registering. So we're a little bit less than that. So that's 10.2 volts, our 12 volt light is lit. If we just wind it back a bit, can we go a little bit lower? Yeah, we got there. Let's get it to, yeah, so up we go. So we're going now beyond 12 volts. Let's see when it flicks over to suggest that we're at 24. There we go, just there. So it's slightly under where 24 volts would be. There is the 24 volts. We can take it up again. It will make an audible noise when we get to 50. Remember, this is DC. So up we go. Audible noise kicked in at around about 40 volts. And we can take it all the way up now to the maximum of 50 volts that this can output here. So you can see now we've got our DC. We went through the 12 volts, the 24 and the 50 volts range. And we're measuring this in DC. And we use these 4mm plugs in order to make the connection into our lab power supply. So looking at the probes themselves, we've got L2 and a positive, L1 and a negative. So what we can do with our DC supply, if we look at the screen here, you can also see the positive and negative. So if I connect this with the positive one, the positive LED will illuminate, likewise with the negatives. Let's see that in action as well. So we're going to put this probe into the black section here, which we expect to be the negative, and this probe into the red, which we expect to be positive. So when we go in, you can see that this probe indicates that it is the positive probe. Okay, so that's a positive connection on the DC supply. The only way to confirm that really is to swap them over. If we do swap them over, we'd expect this one, when it moves to here, actually to illuminate the negative one. So let's pull those out, swap them over, and now we go in again. You can see that it's indicating that this one is connected to the negative of the DC supply. So that gives you the polarity as well. I'm sure everyone can think of a practical application for the voltage indicator when we're looking at AC. Give us a practical application for the DC.
Well, DC students, you probably also, you've just started an electrical course, you probably just bought a, and possibly passed your driving test and got a car, and you want to retrofit that enormous amplifier to the boot. So yeah, you're going to have to tap into the car's electrical supply. So great, great piece of kit for doing that.
It's a double win then. Gaz is telling you at college in the old days to buy one, and you can also use it for DC on your car. So we've talked about AC, so it's fundamental principles, isn't it, that we have a voltage indicator to prove a circuit is live or dead, what we proving?
Well, yeah, dead, hopefully.
Yeah, we are, with the ability to prove that it would be live. Okay, so should we go through that sequence?
Let's have a look at
that. So let's use the Metrel voltage indicator to prove a circuit is dead. So let's think of the process that's already happened. We've identified the circuit, we've locked it off, okay, we've put signs up, we've seen items in the area that we're using that circuit be de-energized. We've taken off the cover and we're going to prove that this socket outlet is now dead and not prove it is live, okay? Maybe we're replacing it, etc. So we're going to use the voltage indicator live, so we need to conform to GS38. So I'll take my shrouded tips and I'm going to screw those on, and you can already see that's nowhere near the maximum of 4mm that can be allowed under GS38. So we're well under that. Let's pop those two on. And obviously we need to prove that this voltage indicator is working correctly, and that's where the proving unit comes in. So I'm going to pop it into the proving unit and we should get it up to the 690 volts, like so. So we now know it's healthy and good to use. We'll now prove that this socket outlet is dead. So I'm going to probe on to, let's go for my neutral and my line. Then I'm going to do my CPC neutral, And then I'm going to do my CPC and my line conductor. Okay, so we've proved that this socket outlet is dead. We're still not happy to prove that this voltage indicator is working correctly. Hasn't failed during the process. So in order to do that, we go back into here and we're going to prove it again. Okay, so now we're actually happy that we've proved that that socket outlet is dead. Maybe we now replace it. Okay, yeah, so there we used it to prove a circuit was dead. The GS38 kicked in there. Now, I've had a little look on the back there. There's a lot of blurb on there, and I like to throw you a bone, Gordon. So let's have a look at some of the blurb, and you can explain some of it to me.
Again, it's that important safety documentation. So look on the back here so you can see it's... if you read GS38, it will reference a BS version of this European standard here, which obviously means it passes all those essential safety tests.
Oh, right, okay. And also the IP rating of the actual unit?
So that's not on here, but this is rated to IP64. So, yeah, you could probably leave it in your toolbox during first fix, you know, when there's a lot of dust around on site, and probably it wouldn't, if you spilt your coffee over it, it's not going to damage the unit. So probably, better than some multimeters out there. That obviously might be another option if you're looking at this.
This is obviously entry-level Metrel items, and we've looked at plenty on the channel. And I recommend, if you haven't seen those videos, to go and check those out. We'll leave the links in the description below. However, are you considering buying a voltage indicator? Are you going to be looking at the MD1160? Have you used it before and you've got some great points you want to share with the community? We'd love to have all of that feedback. Can you please leave those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.